In game theory, we aim to deduce how an actor will act in a given situation. There are a number of factors that affect an actor's choice. These include the actions of other actors in the same situation and the rewards and penalties associated with each possible outcome. Thus, the rewards and penalties, or economic incentives, in a game can be manipulated to change the actor's choice of action. The most commonly used economic incentives in blockchains are tokens, units of protocol-defined cryptocurrency given out to miners, and also privileges, decision-making rights miners can charge for. For the purpose of our analysis, we'll assume that the underlying objective for actors in our crypto economic games is to maximize their profit, which is equal to their revenue minus their costs. The economic incentives at hand here, then, are that we must change the actor's expected profit outcome in order to change the actor's choice. We can incentivize actors to act a certain way using the carrot and stick theory, where we offer carrot rewards like increasing token balances or privileges for good behavior, and offer stick punishments like decreasing tokens or privileges for bad behavior. Another method to incentivize actors to do the right thing is by using a security margin. A crypto economic security margin is an amount of money, X, such that either some requirement G is satisfied or all actors violating G will be poorer by at least X. Actors must decide to either lose X sum of money or abide by the rules of the game. To enforce acceptance of the security margin, we use something called a crypto economic proof, where messages signed by the actor are interpreted as confirmations of their decisions, that either some proposal is true or the miner agrees to suffer the economic loss. Let's take a step back now and think about how we can deduce how actors will act in situations given these incentive structures. To solve this problem, we'll be using the game theory model of normal form games. Normal form games have a set of N actors who each have a set of A possible actions. Their expected payoff from the game depends on the outcome. In the uncoordinated choice model, actors must make decisions without coordinating with other actors. While each actor will know the incentives and best response strategy of every other actor, actors cannot work together to decide upon their actions. Thus, all the actors in such a game have separate incentives. To motivate correct behavior, a good incentive mechanism would set the security margin to be higher than each of the individual incentives. The fixed collection of actions the players of the game will ultimately take is known as the Nash equilibrium. The Nash equilibrium is the state from which no actor can change their action to receive a better outcome. Let's now take this abstract theory and implement it in a real-life situation. Suppose a situation in which there are two prisoners, prisoner A and prisoner B, who were recently detained for robbing a bank. The inspector separates the criminals into two different rooms and interrogates them. To each, he gives the choice to turn the other prisoner in or remain silent. If both prisoners remain silent, they'll both suffer 5 years in prison. If one prisoner remains silent but the other prisoner turns him in, then the silent prisoner will bear responsibility for the whole crime and face 20 years in prison, while the snitch will face 0 years in prison. Finally, if both prisoners decide to turn the other in, they'll both face 10 years in prison. Since the prisoners are separated, they must make the decision individually and cannot coordinate with the other. So what will the prisoners decide? If prisoner B chooses to remain silent, prisoner A will choose to speak, because in doing so, he can get 0 years of prison time instead of the 5 years he would get if he also remained silent. If prisoner B chooses to speak, then prisoner A will again choose to also speak, because the 10-year penalty of them both speaking is still less than the 20-year penalty of prisoner A remaining silent while prisoner B speaks. We can deduce the same best response strategies for prisoner B. Thus, we are left with a situation where given any action of the opponent, each prisoner benefits more from speaking rather than remaining silent. This outcome is our Nash equilibrium. Given the state where both prisoners speak, neither prisoner can change only their decision to get a better sentence. This is called the prisoner's dilemma, where both prisoners end up with a 10-year sentence, even though they could have both gotten only a 5-year sentence if they had both remained silent. Now let's take a look at an example where there are two Nash equilibria. Here's the traditional example. Suppose a man and woman are deciding where to go on a date, boxing or shopping. If they both go boxing, the man will be slightly happier than the woman. If they both go shopping, the woman will be slightly happier than the man. However, if they choose different options, neither will be happy at all because they won't go on a date together. Thus, both going boxing and both going shopping are the Nash equilibria, from which no one character can change their decision to receive a better payoff. Since there are two such Nash equilibrium outcomes, the two agents must coordinate to align their actions to each other and pick one of the outcomes. In coordinated games, the actors in the protocol are controlled by the same agent. We're now going to look at another example of such games in the context of crypto economics. Schelling coin is a thought problem Vitalik came up with to teach principles of crypto economics. In this example, suppose you're a sensor oracle and you must answer the question, what is the right way to orient a toilet paper roll? Well, let's take a look back to choice models to see how we can deal with this situation. You'll get the reward P only if you vote with the majority. Here, there are two Nash equilibria. Everyone could vote A, and you could vote A and get the reward. Or everyone could vote B, and you could also vote B and get the same reward, even if B is the wrong answer. However, in this scenario, we'll assume that players will be incentivized to vote the true answer A, because they want to vote with the majority and believe others will choose the same, given the same choices. Someone who wants the oracle to converge on the wrong answer can do so using the bribing attacker game. Let's say Nadir is voting now, and he saw the majority was going to vote for A. However, I really want him to vote for B. I can promise Nadir that I will pay him P plus Epsilon if and only if Nadir votes for B, but the majority votes for A. Nadir, under the belief that he is the only one who got this deal, will vote for B, thinking everyone else will vote for A. However, I meanwhile have been giving every single actor the same deal, and each person thinks, like Nadir, to switch their vote to B, not knowing everyone else is doing the same. In the end, everyone votes for B, and I, the attacker, do not have to pay any money in bribes, since I only agreed to paying the bribe if each actor voted for B while the majority voted for A.